Hey everybody, it's B again. And yeah, I know it's been a week or 7 days or whatever. I haven't been really doing a lot. I mean, I've been really, really, really lazy. Which is not a good thing. No, not a good thing at all, but I can't help it. Anyways, I'm doing this before I have to go to work. You're like, work. You know what I'm talking about. My volunteer at 10,000 Villages. Anyways, I found this new messenger. I'm not really sure what you would call it, but it's for gamers. And I thought it was stupid cat. Yes, my cat is stupid. Chucky, go away. So, I decided, the only reason I found out about it was, okay, I'm not sure if you guys all know, but I really, really like, Kate, or Cater17 or something like that. She's on YouTube. She's a big YouTuber. Anyways, so she made a she was part of a, like, recording for the video for the game. I don't know if it was like trailer or something, but she was part of that and it's like really, really cool. And she has like, so I'm downloading the game. I downloaded it on this computer, the one I'm using to record this. But for some reason it won't work. So I'm moving it to my lovely laptop over here. So maybe it will work. So my laptop seems to work better for some things than the main computer. This is the main computer, my laptop over here. But anyways, so I'm still using X-Fire, I think it's called. Yes. And it has communities and things. You could talk to each other while you're playing the game. And I thought that was kind of cool, except I don't know anybody on it. I feel kind of bad because I don't know anybody. And it's like, what am I supposed to do? But I know there's like Sims 3 communities on there, so maybe I'll make some Sim 3 friends and we'll talk while we play the game and stuff. I don't know if I mentioned this, but I fudged up the Sims 3 on my desktop. Then I fixed it. So now it works. But after I had been playing The Sims 3 through my mom's desktop for about a week, and I had gotten through a huge gap, a huge thing with my Sims. I made these two Sims that I really, really like. And yes, I'm talking a lot about The Sims. Anyways, so when I fixed the problem, I'm like, oh. Because I'm like all sad because the Sims are totally on a different desktop now. What I did was upload the Sims and download them onto my desktop into my Sims 3 launch thingy, and then downloaded them into the game, into my game on my desktop, so then I could play them. And so now I have to restart their lives in a sense to play them on here. And I'm like, I'm sad because when I started them, and the mom worked as a teacher, and the dad, well, he was doing what he wanted to do. He wants to be a rock star, so he's been working in the music thing. And then the other Sims in the parallel universe, I should probably call it, already have two kids, and they're both they're both children, age, but I sent them to boarding school because it's hard to focus on the parents' jobs when you have to take care of the kids too. And see, I like having kids. I like having my Sims have kids because I have to wait to have kids. So I feel like they're all my kids, and people think I'm weird because it's like, they're like my kids and my great-grandbabies and my great-great-grandbabies, and people think I'm weird because I think them of my children. I know they're my digital children, but still, they're my children. I make them, I raise them, I help them get jobs and skills and love lives and stuff. So I feel like I'm a mom, but other people think I'm weird who play The Sims because they think more in like, I'm God, I can do whatever I want to them. And I'm like, well, I tried to be mean to The Sims a long time ago, a long, long time ago, where I would kill them off when I didn't like them. I try not to do that anymore, because I feel guilty. And it's like, wait, why do you feel guilty? They have no souls. They're not real. So, in a sense, it's killing me. Yes, I'm crazy. I know this. I've been reading a book series called Forbidden Doors, and it's sort of a Christian paranormal book, which is kind of weird to say Christian paranormal in the same sentence, in my opinion. It's pretty good, even though I really don't like reading Christian e-books because I like paranormal. I like the strange and spirits and all that stuff. I like things that some Christians don't like, so meh. I have 67 subscribers, and yeah, so hopefully maybe I can get somewhere. And X-Fire has like this recording stuff and taking pictures stuff, so it might be easier for me to like make videos with the Sims for the Sim in the Sim game stuff. Yeah, so I'll go. Bye.